Hi everyone, so today is day 25 of September Lead Coding Challenge and this is the problem we will be solving today. So the problem name is shortest path in a grid with obstacles elimination. So in usual obstacle shortest path in a grid problem, we are like asked to minimum number of steps so that one can go from this cell to this cell, basically from top left cell to the bottom right cell, and the movement should only be from movement should only be one cell left, one cell right, one cell up and one cell down, right? So using these four kinds of steps, what is the minimum number of steps to move from this top left cell to bottom right cell? So this is the usual problem, but one more thing is that in this matrix, some cells have got value 0, some cells have got value 1. So the cells that have got value 1, those are basically obstacles. So we have to consider a way that is not made up of only zeros. And we are not crossing any cell which has got one, because one is an obstacle here, right? So in usual problem, we are not allowed to move through any obstacle. But in this problem, there is one modification. So the modification is that we can eliminate at most k obstacles. So we can choose to eliminate at most k obstacles. And after doing that, after using this privilege or power or any advantage, we need to tell what is the minimum number of steps using which we can reach the bottom right cell if we start from the top left cell. And we can now consider all the examples. So the first example, the grid is this and k is 1. So if k will be 0, then this would be the answer. So in the example, we can see that the shortest path without eliminating any obstacle is 10. So the path that I was pointing in the start has got 10 steps. And if we are eliminating one obstacle, so the shortest path with one obstacle elimination is at position 3, 2. So at 3, 2, we can eliminate this path and then we can cover this whole. 3, 2 is this. So we can go from this, go towards, first we can go this way and then we can go this way. So this will be a 6-step path if we are eliminating this 3, 2 obstacle. Similarly, in the example, second example, this is the matrix and we are allowed to eliminate one obstacle. So what do you think? What would be the optimal way, best way to eliminate the obstacle? So if we consider eliminating any obstacle, we can see that suppose we are eliminating this obstacle, right? So if we are eliminating this obstacle, we can see that the path is still blocked. And similarly, if we are eliminating this obstacle, this is not helping us either. So we may try to eliminate all these obstacles to see what is happening. And we'll find that eliminating any of the obstacle of all the obstacles present in this matrix won't unblock this path. It is not possible to reach from top left to bottom right cell if we are allowed to eliminate only one obstacle. So in that case, it is not possible to reach from the top left to the bottom right. We have to output -1. So these are the explanation of the two examples. So we can take a look to the constraints. So we can see that the m is the grid length and grid I dot length is n. So basically, this is M here and this is N here, right? There are m cells and n columns, and both these m and n are ranging from 1 to less than equal to 40, and the number of obstacles that we are allowed to eliminate can range from 1 to m into n. So basically this is from ranging from 1 to the total number of cells present in the matrix, and each value of present in the cell is either 0 or 1. So 0 means like that cell is free, and 1 means that cell has got an obstacle. And the first cell, this is the first, like this is the bottom top left cell, and this is the bottom right cell. So these cells are always empty. So these were the constraints. Now we can try to understand how we'll be solving this problem. So the problem in which there are no obstacles, like we are not given the privilege to, like we are not given any feature or advantage or like help of eliminating the obstacle. What we do, we like start a BFS from the top left, right, yeah, from here, top left cell, and we like keep track of how many steps are traveled by every node or every cell that we push into the queue. So we will what we do, and when we reach this cell, then whatever is the number of steps present in that the node that we pushed. So basically what we push x comma y comma number of steps taken so far in a queue. So every time we pop this item, this quantity, this vector, basically we will be using vector to to store these three quantities. So whenever we pop this vector, what we do, we consider all these cells. We consider the cell towards its left, we consider the cell towards its right, towards its bottom, and towards its towards its up, right? And what we do, whatever was the steps in this vector, like in this for this vector, we push the another vector with steps plus one. So whatever, if suppose the number of steps is present in this vector is s, right? Then we will be pushing another vector with s plus one here, and x and y coordinate, respective x and y coordinates of that cell. So this is what we do in case of no obstacle elimination, right? So in case of obstacle elimination, what we will be doing, we will also be having one more parameter k. So we'll be pushing how many obstacles we are still allowed to eliminate. So first of all, we will start this BFS with these things x. So x will be 0 here, y will be 0, and this k will be k, and the number of steps will be 0. So we will start the BFS by pushing this quantity in the queue. And now what we will be doing, we'll be checking all these four cells towards its left, towards its right, towards its up, and towards its down, right? So if there will be obstacle on any of the cell, then what we do, we will push the new vector with k minus 1 instead of k, because we have already eliminated one obstacle. And if there won't be any obstacle on the cell that we are considering, then we will push with k parameter k. And just in case the no like the vector that we just popped out of the queue has got value k equal to 0, then we won't initiate any other node for on which there is an obstacle, because for that k will be minus 1, and we are not allowed to remove more than k obstacles. And there is one more thing that we may repeat the same state again. So it may be possible that we will again push the same thing, like x, same y, and same k, the vector with say these same things. So we will again use a visited vector. So we'll be using a 3D matrix, like 3D what 3D vector. So this will contain whether the same state has been already been visited or not. So if it's the same state has been visited, we won't be pushing that into queue, because like pushing that thing again won't help, because if the same state was pushed earlier in the queue, that would have got a minimum more l less number of steps than this time. That would have got a less than equal to the steps that we are having this time, and that will also like increase the complexity. So if we are like considering these things, like considering pushing only unvisited states, then we can do this problem in how much. So we can do this in n into m into k. So k is ranging from 0 to ranging from 1 to m into n. So we can do it in n square into m square time complexity. And seeing that, we can see that that will be 40 to the power 4, and 4 to the power 4 is in fact 256, and there will be 4 zeros towards its right. So like this will be able to pass all the test cases. So yeah, our algorithm is optimal enough to pass all the test cases. So we can start implementing this. So we can get rid of this diagram, and now we can implement it. So first of all, we'll be storing the m. So m here is the number of rows. So that will be grid dot size, and n will be grid 0 dot size. So now we have got these two things. Now we will need a vector, nested vector, right? So it will be a 3D Boolean vector, and we can call it visited. So it will tell us whether a state is visited or not. So it will have dimension m cross n cross k. I am using k plus 1 here because the value of k can range from 0 to k. So that's why we need k plus 1. And the value of these things will only range from 0 to m minus 1 and 0 to n minus 1. So now we have got the visited 3D vector. We will need one more thing, and that will be q. So this q will be a q of vectors. And I will call it nodes. So first of all, we will be pushing the like top left node, right, in it. So the top left node will have dimensions 0 comma 0, and it will have k equals to k, and the number of steps will be 0, right? And we have to make sure we are marking this node as visited. So 0, 0, k is now visited. And then we can use a while loop. So we have to keep running this while loop until this node is not empty. And first of all, we'll be pushing, like popping the node at the front. So I will call it node. So this front will store its value, and this nodes dot pop will pop it out. So now we have got this node. So we need to make sure this node, so just in case this node is the bottom right cell. So in that case, node 0 will be equals to m minus 1, and node 1 will be equals to n minus 1, right? So just in case it is true, then we have reached to the bottom right cell, and then we can return the number of steps. So number of steps will be the node 3. The first one, 0 is the number row numbers, the 1 is the column number, 2 is the number of like obstacles you can still eliminate, and the 3 is the number of steps. So if it is not the case, then we will be checking the cell on the left. So first we'll be checking whether the node 0 minus 1 is greater than equals to 0 or not, because if it this condition is not true, then we will like run into runtime error. So now we have done this, then what we need to ensure, so we need to ensure, like we need to check which type of cell is the left cell, whether it is a cell containing the obstacle or whether it is a cell like free cell, right? So if the cell is a cell containing obstacle, then grid of node 0, grid of node 0 minus 1, node 1, this will be 1, right? And similarly, we will handle the case when it is not 1. So if it is 1, then we need to check whether it has been visited or not, right? And there is one more thing we need to check. So we need to check the present case. So the present case stored in node 2 is greater than equal to 1 or not. Because if we are considering a cell with the obstacle, we still need the power of having like of removing or at least one cell, at least one obstacle. So this condition will check that, and then we can check whether it has been visited or not. So if it is not visited, node 0 minus 1, node 1, and there goes node 2, right? So if it is not visited, then we will mark it visited. This quantity needs to be marked visited. So it has been now marked visited. Then we can push this node into our nodes queue. So the thing that will be pushed is node 0 minus 1, node 1, and it should be node 2 minus 1. Okay. So it should be node 2 minus 1 here also, because we will be eliminating one obstacle to consider this node. And the number of steps will be node 3 plus 1. One more than the previous. Okay, so we need to now we need to consider the case when there are no obstacles. So in that case, we will check whether the cell is visited or not. So the procedure will be same. Only thing is that we don't need to check whether the number of obstacle that we can still eliminate is greater than 1, greater than or equal to 1, and here it shouldn't be minus 1. So we have now written the code for the left cell. Now we need to do the same thing for top cell, right? So for that, top cell node 1 minus 1 should be greater than or equal to 0. And here it should be node 1 minus 1. Here, instead of every node 0 minus 1, we can do node 1 minus 1. Almost done. So we have handled the case of top cell also. Now we need to handle the case of right cell. So we can copy this thing. So now we need to check whether this node 0 plus 1 is less than equal to M. No, we are not considering right cell because we are increasing the row number. So we are considering down cell here, and it was code for the top cell, and this was the code for the right cell. So apologies for using the wrong terms. So now we are considering what? We are considering one, like the next row, right? So we are considering the down cell. So here at every minus one, we can do plus one. And yeah, that is much easier to do. So we have now handled this case also. Similarly, we can replace all plus one, minus one to plus one here. And this is the, so we are increasing the column number. So this is basically the right cell. So we need to check whether this node one plus one is less than n or not. So if it is less than n, then we can do this. So now after we have, okay. So we have done a mistake. We need to do plus one here. Okay, I guess we have implemented this code. So all these four cells have been handled. And if we are reaching the final cell, we are returning the number of steps. And what if we are not reaching? So that is the case when it is not possible to reach the last cell. So in that case, we'll be returning minus one. So now we can try to run it on the sample test cases to check if we have got some compilation error or what. So yeah, it is working on the sample test cases. We can submit it. Yeah, it got accepted. So see you guys on day 26. Until then, keep reading coding.